This is the fifth international cyber conference that we are conducting here at Tel Aviv University. Those of you that presented, that were here in the previous four, I'm sure noted that in the previous cases it was organized by Tel Aviv University and the Yuval Ne'eman Workshop for Science, Technology and Security, and this time it's done by the Blavatnik Interdisciplinary Cyber Research Center at Tel Aviv University, which was, by the way, the setup of it was announced here last year in the conference that the fourth international conference that we had here. This center is a result of a kind of evolution of the concept of cybersecurity that happened here in Israel in the last 20 years or something like this. This is one step in the evolution. And when we realized that in order to have a real living ecosystem that will react in automatically in a way to changes in technology and changes in threats, etc., we understood that we should take care of all the elements. One of them is university centers of excellence in cyber research. And the first one that was set up by the INCB, by the Bureau, and Tel Aviv University was here at Tel Aviv University, the second one in Beersheba, and there are more to come. We have five research universities, and I guess at the end of the day, most of them or a large part of them will have centers like this as well. If I would have to summarize the major steps in the evolution of the concept, I would say that, like, I mean, cyber research, cyber technology is a result of computerization, very fast rate of computerization of everything in our life. At the beginning, it was something done by intelligence services because computers were the main tool for storing information. And therefore, the first stage in the evolution was what we called then information security. Then we realized that information security, it's not enough. Because computers are not only storing information, they are controlling other systems in our life, and someone can use the same technique in order to hack into those computer chips which control different systems in our life, like power production. And therefore, information security is not enough. We went into the second stage, which is cybersecurity. And even this is not enough. Lately, in the last few years, we realize, I mean, people are speaking about Internet of Things and home devices communicating with other home devices through computers without men in the loop, or almost without men in the loop. Smart cities, smart nations, smart cars, things like this. And all these wonderful visions will never work unless you can have a certain level of security. Because you cannot really let the bad guys, and there will always be bad guys, use or abuse this new technology in order to shut off electricity or things like this. In order to speak about the evolution of cyber concepts in Israel generally, and especially what happened here in the last years, I would like to invite now the director of INCB, of Israel National Cyber Bureau, we will have a kind of conversation between us. I will interview him and talk about the INCB and what happened in the past, what do we have to expect in future. Dr. Eviatar Matania, please.
Okay, another demonstration of the role of computers in our life. Dr. Matania Eviatar, you were appointed by the Prime Minister to be the head of INCB 3.5 years ago, on January 2011. And as far as 2012, and as far as I understand, were asked also to extend it for another term. Now, can you say, looking back with the hindsight, what were the three major achievements of INCB during this time?
Yes, you know, Itzik, that. Looking from the future to the past, it's much easier because I can say what we did and what we expected to do. But if I have to nail three major achievements or challenges that we try to fulfill, I can point toward these. One is the building the capacity of Israel in the cyber domain. I think this was one of our major missions, to start building the ecosystem of universities, industry, and human capital in Israel in order to be one of the powers in the world in cybersecurity. No doubt that it was based on what we already had, because the Israeli cybersecurity industry started more than 20 years ago, and most of the people here, I believe, know the company named Checkpoint and other companies. And based on the Israeli cybersecurity industries that have already been there, and the capabilities of universities in the areas which are related to cybersecurity, and also on the fact that we had, I think, the first resources of human capital in the area of cybersecurity, we thought that this ecosystem should be maintained, strengthened, and we, the government, have to do a lot in order to take it forward as building the Israeli capacity, not just to be, but also to remain, and in 5 to 10 years in the future, be one of the powers in the world. So I think this was one of the first major challenges. And in this, you know that we have just established the 5 research centers, which you mentioned. The first 2 were the Tel Aviv University and Ben-Gurion University research centers. We have already established Bar Ilan and Hebrew University cyber research centers, and we are currently working with the Technion to also establish their research center. Together, all the 5 complete each other. Everyone is focused on another issue, and I think it will give us a real strength in the future. And we made a lot of work together with the industry, together with the chief scientists in the Ministry of Economy and other colleagues of us in the government to try and bring here more global companies to open the research centers here, to encourage our startups and cybersecurity industry in Israel, to help them in the export efforts and all other things which are needed. And last but not least is the human capital. We have a strategic plan for how to enlarge and make it more qualitative. So this was one major mission to build the Israeli capacity. The second one was to develop the Israeli comprehensive national cyber security strategy, which we did. And you also, during the last step, were part of it. You were asked to support. And this was ended just on February 15, when the government adopted 2 resolutions regarding our strategy for the next decade. I think this was another very important challenge and mission that we succeeded to fulfill. And the last one I will point towards, I know that it's not maybe from a national perspective, but from a governmental perspective, to succeed in parallel to these activities, to also establish the bureau. I started, as you know, as one man in the bureau on January 1st, 2012, and to establish a new organization, the government, which I try to build as an excellent organization. And it's quite difficult. It's a real mission to succeed to do it. It's not an easy task to build new things. You are now responsible for establishing the Cyber Resource Center in the university. You know how difficult it is in big corporations like university or the government to build and establish such an organization.
Thank you. So you spoke about capacity building, about including human capital, not only technology, of course, and about the effort of establishing the role and the status of this national cyber bureau, the National Cyber Bureau. Now, these efforts, I assume, will continue also into the future. I mean, these are not one-blow efforts. Can we expect new challenges or new things that may come in the, let's say, next 5 years?
Yes, of course. I think that the first one is the establishing of the new cyber security authority in Israel, which will be the one and only organization responsible for the cyber defense of Israel in the cyber domain from cover to cover. This is a real challenge. We have already started working on it. We are in the first steps of this process. I see it as my main challenge for the coming 3 years, because we have a three-year plan of how to establish it. Again, to establish such an organization that will work close with the civilian market, because it's a civil organization, but also very close with the intelligence community, and to bring to it hundreds of excellent people and to establish all its methods and strategies, this is a real challenge. This is my major challenge in the coming 3 years. The second one is related to the second governmental resolution regarding how to build the market resilience. I think we have some initial steps that we did in this arena, but I think this is my second major challenge for the coming, and it's not just 3 years, it will take much more than that to build the market resilience, and through working with the current regulators, through leading the government to be a leader in the resilience, and other steps that we are going to take. This is the second challenge, meaning that the first major challenges are to fulfill and work according to the two governmental resolutions from February 15. I will just mention one more, which I see as a very important one, which is the international arena. Although we have quite very good relations and cooperation with several countries around the world, and we are present in several forums which relates to cybersecurity, I think that looking at the future, a great mission is to position Israel far ahead in the international arena, working much closer with our allies, being more present in all these forums, and also influence the way that the world is going to be built with its norms, legal issues, and other cooperation in this field. This is another major task that I see for the future, and this will take much more than 3 years.
Thank you. Now, this conference that we are now participating in was arranged by the Blavatnik Interdisciplinary Cyber Research Center of Tel Aviv University, which is not only the first one that was set up with the help of your bureau, but also I think the biggest one. We have something like 250 researchers in the center, 50 faculty members, professors, and the rest are PhD, postdoc students, etc. And as you say, this is only the first step towards building centers like this in all the major universities of Israel. Can you be a little bit more specific on what, in your eyes, what should be the role of the academia generally in promoting the goals of the cyber policy of Israel?
I think that the five research centers in general, and this one in particular, which is an interdisciplinary center, are of most importance to the Israeli ecosystem in cybersecurity. As you probably know, this was one of the first steps that I took, because I think that one cannot talk about power in cybersecurity, cannot talk about how to be leaders in cybersecurity without a very clear academic leadership. I think that the university should first work very close with the government and industry in order to help them in creating new solutions, new technologies that will enable us to better defend ourselves. Second, I am expecting these research centers to also produce us with new thinking that do not answer questions, because I expect them to bring new thinking that we don't know what to ask in order to receive these answers. I am expecting the universities to bring knowledge, new breakthrough technologies that will enable us to balance the currently unbalanced equation between attackers and defenders in this field. I expect the universities to help us in developing the human capital in this country. I think that they have a major role in all of these fields, and leading universities also enable us to be a leader country in this field.
It was mentioned here this morning by the president of Tel Aviv University, and as well as his Excellency the Ambassador of the U.S., that Israeli share in cyber technology sales is much bigger than the proportion of Israel to the rest of the world. The estimates go something between 5 to 10%, depends on different ways of weighing it, of measuring it. What is, as head of Cyber National Bureau, what is your message to the industry, and what should be their part in the overall vision of Israel as a cyber power, in a sense, from the standpoint of technology?
I see the Israeli cybersecurity industry as very important to both our national cybersecurity strategies and our ability to defend Israel, but also for our economy. Meaning that in cybersecurity we have a very interesting synergy between our security needs and economical needs. The industry is exactly the one that bridges this gap. And currently we have a lot of new startups, a lot of innovative ideas in this issue. We have companies that are currently growing up. I think that in this issue, a lot of good things are happening, but trying to look to the future, I also expect that the Israeli industry will succeed not just to produce new startups every day, but also to produce growing, grown-up companies, will be able to enter into not just producing new technologies and solutions, but also to integration of cybersecurity technologies and products, to services, to be much more present in the world than we are currently there. If we succeed to do that, I believe that the future of the industry and the future of the Israeli capacity will be in the right place. So integration services, entering into new fields, the SCADA systems, that not that we are not there, we have everything. We have the startups, we have grown up companies, we have SCADA solutions, we have other good things, but looking to the future, I think that integration and services and our ability to have much more grown-up companies and new products and solutions in new areas are the key to a well-developing industry.
Okay, usually when we speak about the Israeli ecosystem for technology, including cyber technology, we speak about three elements. Two of them you already mentioned, and one is the academia, of course, the other one is industry. The third one is government. In cybersecurity, it may be more defense agencies of the government, but still government. And as we know, government is not only defense, but also other ministries which are relevant, like education ministry, etc. Can you talk a little bit about this third wheel in the ecosystem?
Yes. By establishing the Cyber Bureau, the government didn't mean to replace all the current ministries and agencies working with the market, with the industry, with universities. We see ourselves as those who are responsible to take all these ministries and agencies together and to direct all of them together with us to the right directions, viewing cyber as one of the major issues of Israel for the coming decades, as a key stone in its economy and national security. And now we work very close with the Ministry of Education, Ministry of Economy, Ministry of Science and Technology, of course the Ministry of Treasury, and all the rest in order to produce this ecosystem. I see the government role as to enable the market, to support the market, and to help everyone which wants to be there to really succeed in building new industry. For example, the CyberSpark in Be'er Sheva. This is something which is based on the industry, on the Cyber Research Center of the Ben-Gurion University, but we also have a role in it. First, we are going to put there the national cert in the beginning of next year. We are now in the end of the process of legislation of some tax breaches to this area for cyber companies. And I see the role of the government as an enabler. We do the legislation, we bring what we can bring, we encourage others to do. And this is a very, I would say, you should know how to work with the industry, not to replace the free market and the industry or the universities, but to be there when needed. This is the way I see it, and this is what we are trying to do with all the other ministries, the agencies in the government in order to encourage this.
Speaking about the government, just got a note saying that the Prime Minister will be late by half an hour, so we will make a slight change in the program. And the sessions that we plan to have after the Prime Minister, we will have it now, and then the Prime Minister will come and will go as usual. So thank you very much, and hope to see you same place, same time next year. Thank you.
Thank you.